Greetings, I am Dr. Latasia Jones, a proud alum of the Virginia State University. I am also the founder of STEMming While Black, which is a movement and an organization that provides guidance and mentorship from current Black leaders in STEM to future leaders in STEM. I am here to introduce you to the largest and the longest compilation through video that will spotlight Black leaders in STEM who were all prepared by amazing HBCUs. This event is brought to you by the HBCU STEMulUS, STEMming Forward, HBCU STEAM, Bridge Alliance, STEMming While Black, and Hey Dr. Tay. Pull up a seat and have an amazing time.
Greetings, my name is Taylor Vett Dismuke, and I'm proud to say I am a 2015 biology graduate from the Lynx University, the only HBCU in Oklahoma, and the real LU. Lace has taught me so many things. One of those is to walk into any room and command attention and then demand respect. Because of my experience at Lace and the support of my family and faculty, I decided to pursue my master's in biochemistry at Texas State University. And immediately following, I'm currently pursuing my doctoral degree at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill in pathology and translational sciences, where my current work looks at improving drug treatments and the treatment of childhood brain cancer. Langston has truly been my passport to the world. Because of my experiences interested in STEM in undergrad, I developed a STEM outreach initiative called BRDGE Alliance. BRDGE Alliance is a peer mentoring program focused on HBCU undergraduate students and connecting them with Black graduate students across the nation. We're here to empower, relate, and develop. I am HBCU made.
Hello, everyone. My name is Crystal L. Gans, and I graduated from the illustrious Elizabeth City State University, which is an HBCU in Elizabeth City, North Carolina. S.T.E.M.U. Viking Pride! I earned my Bachelor of Science in Biology and my minor in Chemistry in 2014, and I can honestly say that me attending my HBCU was one of the best decisions that I've ever made for my career as well as for my life in general. It allowed me to see people that looked like me striving for greatness and putting in the work to get it done. I was able to realize my potential, and one of the defining moments for me at ECSU was becoming involved in the Minority Access to Research Careers or MARC Scholars Program. In that program, I was exposed to undergraduate research. I was able to travel to different conferences and meetings to present that research and see people from other fields pursuing their degrees as well as learning more about graduate school. Additionally, I was able to complete a couple of summer internship opportunities, one of them being at Duke University and the other at University of Florida. Attending my HBCU also helped me realize my potential and helped me get the confidence to pursue my dream. And I'm living my dream right now. I'm a doctoral candidate at the University of Wisconsin-Madison in the Endocrinology and Reproductive Physiology program. My research focuses on understanding extracellular matrix, or ECM, alterations in high-grade serous ovarian cancer. And I'm due to graduate next year. Additionally, I am the founder of STEMming Forward, which is an initiative that focuses on the recruitment, the retainment, the encouragement, and the support of Black and Brown scholars as they pursue their own educational paths, specifically focusing on advanced degrees in STEM, masters, and PhDs. I am a first-generational college graduate. I am a first-generational graduate student, and I will be the first doctor in my family. And I am HBCU made.
You're talking out the side of your neck, the side of your neck. Hey y'all, my name is Isha Clyde, and I'm a proud graduate of the North Carolina Central University. Funk! You know? Where I graduated in 2015 with my bachelor's degree in biology. I later went on to Towson University in Towson, Maryland, where I received my master's degree in biology in 2018. Currently, I'm a laboratory scientist. I study the immune responses of HIV-1 infection and how those responses can be induced by AIDS vaccine candidates.
I'm also the founder of a new organization called the HBCU STEMulUS. And our mission is to educate, train, and develop students at historically Black colleges and universities for successful careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. And guess what, y'all? Your girl is HBCU made. Ayo, ayo, ay. You're talking out the side of your neck. The side of your neck. Do, 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 do.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Dr. Jalal A. Hayes, also known as Dr. Ja in my community, and I'm a proud two-time HBCU graduate, first from the first degree grant at HBCU, the Lincoln University of Pennsylvania, where we say, L.U., Lincoln Pride, L.U., Lincoln Pride. Tell them why, y'all. 1-8-5-4. First HBCU for sure. 1-8-5-4. First HBCU for sure. Woo! That is the institution where I got my bachelor's of science in general science, as well as history with a minor certification in math before I transitioned to the illustrious first state HBCU, the Delaware State University, where I went and got my doctoral degree in applied chemistry in 2015, where I was named and lauded as the youngest ever to get the degree at the age of 22 years old. I'm 27 now, but that's still a historical feat at the university. My HBCU experience, being a two-time HBCU graduate, has been a humbling yet learning experience through it all. From there, I learned how to code switch. I not only learned my rudiments in STEM, which is science, technology, engineering, mathematics for all my STEM majors out there, I also learned how to navigate all types of spaces when it comes to research, business development, and even talking about things that are regarding energy. And I love both of my HBCUs to my heart, in my soul, and in my veins. Without my HBCUs, I wouldn't be the man I am today. In addition to that, I am blessed to say that I'm an assistant professor back home at Lincoln University of Pennsylvania, as well as being an entrepreneur where I'm the founder of HBCU STEAM, where I aim to give back to the HBCU community by teaching students or entrepreneurs in the HBCU community color in regards to helping them protect their assets, as well as learning about intellectual property throughout their journey, not only in their respective HBCU, but as well as being an entrepreneur once they graduate. Thank y'all so much, and I can't wait for y'all to enjoy this experience. I am HBCU made.
My name is Darian James, and I am a 2015 graduate of the illustrious South Carolina State University. SC State is home to the Marching 101 Band and the lovely Ladies of Champaign. SCSU has graduated over 2,035 minority officers who served in the U.S. Army, over 119 professional athletes, and a notable graduate of SCSU is the Honorable James E. Clyburn. SCSU is so near and dear to my heart because I grew up on campus. I started going to school on campus at the age of 2, and I stayed there up until I graduated from middle school. So as you can imagine, I wanted to get as far away from home as possible to go to college. But I was able to get a full ride by staying at home, and I was also able to get 6 credit hours out of the way. So it was a no-brainer to choose SC State. But something that's important to mention here is that I decided to live on campus so that I could get the full college experience. I wanted to go to the yard shows. I wanted to go to the parties. So I lived on campus, and that was the best decision ever. I also became a member of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated. SC State provided me with so many opportunities like internships, professional development. It's truly priceless when you can go to an HBCU because you have so many people that look like you, that genuinely care about you, that pour into you. You're able to make lifelong friends who truly, truly, truly have your best interest at heart. I can honestly say that getting my Bachelor of Science degree in Nuclear Engineering from SC State was an unforgettable experience. And fun fact, SC State has the only undergraduate nuclear engineering degree in the state of South Carolina and at an HBCU. SC State definitely prepared me for where I am today, and that's at the UW-Madison in Madison, Wisconsin, where I am a doctoral candidate in the biomedical engineering department. I love my SC State. SC State? I am HBCU made.
Greetings, I am Dr. Latasia Jones, a proud alum of the Virginia State University, which was founded on March 6th of 1882. VSU, let's work it. Hey, work it. Hey. Trojans, you know how we do. While at Virginia State University, I earned my bachelor's and my master's in biology. During my master's years, I had an amazing opportunity to travel to Ghana, where I taught English, science, and math. While teaching science, I was so excited about how the students were excited about what I was teaching that I decided I wanted to continue doing these things for the rest of my life, and I want to provide opportunities like these to future generations. I decided then that I wanted to pursue my PhD. 5 years later, I became the first African American to graduate and earn a PhD from the Department of Biomedical Sciences in the College of Medicine at Florida State University. Currently, I am an ethics fellow at the American Society for Microbiology. My research background is in biomedical sciences, molecular biology, and neuroscience. I am a AAAS IF-THEN ambassador, serving as a role model in any and every platform that is available to me. I am the founder of Stemming While Black, which is a movement and an organization that provides guidance from current Black leaders in STEM through mentorship, advice, and networking opportunities, all of which are going to future leaders of STEM. Topics that we cover include imposter syndrome, issues with your confidence, as well as discrimination within your program, and maybe just being the only or the first in your program or in your household. I am the CEO of Hey Dr. Tay LLC STEM Consulting Company, which provides services to school programs, after school programs, mentorship organizations, and so on. I am the founder of Young Scientist Wednesdays, which is a collaboration between myself and the Ronald McDonald House Charities in DC, where we provide services and activities to the patients at Children's National Hospital that allows them to explore STEM through fun activities that they usually wouldn't be able to do at a hospital. I am also the founder of Hey Dr. Tay YouTube channel and Kitchen Science with Dr. Tay, which is my show that allows you to learn how to explore STEM or science in particular from the convenience of your own home using the things that you can find around your house. I am HBCU made.
Hi everyone, my name is Cassine Coles, and for undergrad, I attended Oakwood University, which is an institution located in Huntsville, Alabama, and I earned my bachelor's in biological sciences. For graduate school, I attended the University of Illinois at Chicago, which is an institution located in Chicago, Illinois, and I earned my PhD in anatomy and cell biology. For my work, I investigated how orthodontical homeobox 2 within the ventral tegmental area played a role in ethanol consumption. And I am HBCU made.
My name is Justin Grimes, and I'm an alum of Morehouse College. The house. I graduated in 2017 with my bachelor's degree in sociology with a minor in education studies. Currently, I live in Los Angeles, California, where I work for Spotify on the Soundtrap for Education team as an education specialist. I am HBCU made.
T.U., you know?
My name is Peyton Greenwood, and I graduated from the prestigious Tuskegee University in 2019 with a bachelor's degree in food and nutritional sciences. I am currently a graduate student at The Ohio State University in Columbus, Ohio, pursuing my master's degree in food science and technology. I am HBCU made.
Hi, everybody. My name is Tia Laws Williams. I'm an alum of Howard University, class of 2005. H-U, you know, the real H-U, Bison. Not no Harbor, not no Hampton, Howard. I received my bachelor's in biology and minored in chemistry. I'm currently the founder and CEO of Lucas Pi Bio, a biologics manufacturing company in Philadelphia, PA. I am definitely HBCU made.
My name is Ryan Johnson, or you can call me Dr. RJ. I'm alum of Langston University, where I received my bachelor's degree in chemistry. After Langston, I went to Louisiana State University, where I got my PhD in inorganic chemistry. Without Langston University, I wouldn't be here today. I'm currently assistant professor at Tulsa Community College, where I run my program, Don't Be Scared. Don't Be Scared is a program meant to encourage and inspire the next generation of STEM students. Our end goal is just to let the community know, don't be scared of STEM. It's nothing to be scared of. You can do it too. But let me just show y'all what we do.
Dr. Simone Soso, and I am a two-time HBCU alum. I graduated from the University of Maryland Eastern Shore in 2005 with my bachelor's in general agriculture with a concentration in animal science. I then went on to the illustrious North Carolina A&T to do my master's in animal health science, where I loved it, and I did work with goat reproduction, looking at parasites during goats during pregnancy and determining which factors contributed to their general health. I then went on to do my PhD at Iowa State University in environmental science, where I studied how lions and tigers use their scent markings to communicate chemical messages. I currently work for Quality Education for Minorities, where I'm a program manager and research associate. The mission of QEM is to improve the education of minorities in STEM. So we do this by having workshops, planning sessions, etc., with faculty at minority-serving institutions, as well as other organizations and institutions, so that we can make capacity building a focus at these minority-serving institutions, whether they be HBCUs, HSIs, or TCUs. So, I am HBCU made and happy to say so.
Hey y'all, my name is Valerie Wade, and I am a loyal daughter of the illustrious South Carolina State University, which is in my hometown of Orangeburg, South Carolina, where I graduated summa cum laude with a BS in nuclear engineering, which by the way is the only undergraduate nuclear engineering program in all HBCUs and in all of South Carolina. And this afforded me the opportunity to pursue my PhD at the University of Michigan in Nuclear Engineering and Radiological Sciences, where I am currently researching prompt gamma ray imaging for proton beam verification, which is used for cancer therapy. So if this seems like a brag or like I'm flexing, it's because I am, because I attended the best HBCU in the land. Go Bulldogs, the real Bulldogs. And I am HBCU made.
Greetings. My name is Dr. Siobhan Day Grady. I'm a graduate of Winston-Salem State University, North Carolina Central University, and North Carolina A&T State University. I obtained from both Winston-Salem State University and North Carolina A&T State University degrees in computer science. From North Carolina Central University, I obtained my master's in information science. But at A&T, I was able to do something really great. In 2018, I became the first woman to achieve a PhD in computer science from the university. Now, I work at North Carolina Central University and the School of Library and Information Sciences, where I also happen to get my Master's of Information Science. As you can see, I'm HBCU made.
Hello, my name is Ashley LeCount. I attended South Carolina State University, where I obtained a bachelor's in biology with a minor in chemistry. South Carolina State University gave me the tools that I needed to move on to Georgia Southern University, where I obtained my master's in public health with a concentration in health policy and management. I am currently a chemist at Takeda Biopharmaceutical Company. I am HBCU made.
Hello everyone, my name is Michael Cobb, and I'm here representing my alma mater, the illustrious Elizabeth City State University, located in Elizabeth City, North Carolina, located in northeastern North Carolina, home of the mighty Vikings. ECISU, I love it, I love it, I love it. While at ECISU, I earned a BS in chemistry with a pre-pharmacy concentration. I later decided to further my academic studies at the notorious North Carolina A&T State University, Aggie Pride, where I'm currently a master's candidate in the Master's of Chemistry program. My study focuses on natural products and anti-cancer chemo preventive mechanisms. I'm also involved with a nonprofit in my hometown of Washington, North Carolina. The nonprofit is called Interbank STEM Program. This program focuses on minority youth and exposing them to STEM careers and aviation science. And I am HBCU made.
We're going to rock the blue and white, 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 stop. Let the alumni do it. My name is Crystal Taylor. I am a graduate of the illustrious Hampton University, the standard of excellence, also known as the real HU. I graduated from Hampton University with a bachelor's in molecular biology. I also obtained my master's in medical science. I am currently a second year student at the BRDGE School of Medicine at East Carolina University. My doctoral degree will be in biomedical science with a concentration in pharmacology and toxicology. My current research is on immunotoxicity and how water toxicants affect B cells. I am HBCU made.
My name is Hope Conklin and I attended the Virginia State University, a small HBCU located in Petersburg, Virginia. I graduated in 2015 with my Bachelor of Science in Math and Computer Science. While at Virginia State, I met some of the best friends I will ever make. I met my husband, and I found my passion. From there, I went on to pursue my Master's in Data Analytics from Penn State University, where I was able to help develop an internship program focused on bringing Black and Brown students from all over the country, specifically HBCUs and MSIs, to the university to conduct hands-on research in science, technology, engineering, and math disciplines. Currently, I am a data scientist with Amazon Web Services, and I'm extremely proud to say that I am HBCU made.
Hello, everyone. My name is Alexia Zlampkin. I am an alumna of the unsinkable Albany State University in Albany, Georgia. Everybody get up, get crunk, and do the Ramba. Everybody get up, get crunk, and do the Ramba. Everybody get up, get crunk, and do the Ramba. Buck, 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 buck. I graduated from ASU in 2018. I earned a double bachelor's in forensic science and chemistry. Currently, I am a doctoral candidate at the University of Wisconsin-Madison in molecular and cellular pharmacology. My research focuses on the neurobiological changes that occur after an individual undergoes stress. This stress could lead to a psychiatric disorder based on those neurobiological changes. I am HBCU made.
Hello, my name is Eliza Hilton. I attended the illustrious South Carolina State University, where I obtained a bachelor's degree in nuclear engineering. Attending a HBCU was hands down, the best decision that I could have made. Let me tell you about the networking opportunities. They were amazing. I had multiple internship opportunities, which turned into formal job offers when I graduated. I can definitely say that South Carolina State University prepared me for my career. Currently, I am a resident inspector for the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, and I am proudly HBCU made.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Tamira Butler-Likely, and I graduated from the university that sits on the highest of seven hills in Tallahassee, Florida, where the Rattlers strike again, the Florida A&M University. I graduated in 2006 with my bachelor's in chemistry biochemistry, and I graduated with my PhD in biology and biomedical sciences from Washington University in St. Louis. I completed my postdoc at the National Institutes of Health in Bethesda, Maryland, and I currently reside in the metro Atlanta area. I taught collegiate level life sciences courses for over 13 years, and I currently serve as a first line editor for research grant summary statements. I also own my own editing business, Likely Write Editing, and I own a travel business as well, TNT Travels Group, and I am HBCU made.
My name is Deidre Artis Fayel. I graduated from Winston-Salem State University, Ram Pride, where I received a Bachelor's of Science in Management Information Systems. I also have a Master's of Science from Capital Technology University in Cyber and Information Security. I currently work for the Department of Treasury as a cybersecurity analyst. I am a huge STEM advocate fan. I love to see young girls excel in STEM subjects. I currently work with Girl Scouts of America to help teenage girls achieve their cybersecurity badges. I also volunteer with Girls in Technology, STEM for Her, and Women in Technology. I am HBCU made.
My name is Heather Carroll, and I am a graduate of The Howard University, where I completed my doctorate in neurophysiology. I'm currently a postdoctoral fellow at the University of Maryland, and I am HBCU made. HU, you know?
Greetings, my name is Tashawn D. Gaynor, and I am an alumnus of the Virginia State University, located in Petersburg, Virginia, where I obtained my bachelor's in science, majoring in business management with a minor in accounting. I am currently employed at Pratt & Whitney Aerospace, located in East Hartford, Connecticut, where I serve as a proactive supplier quality engineer for our fan module center. My experience at Virginia State was very, very enjoyable, to say the least. It was an honor to go to such a prestigious HBCU, where I was able to meet an abundance of so many amazing individuals. A lot of the reason why I chose to attend Virginia State University is because, for opposite reasons of many people that look like me, my high school was predominantly African American. It was very, very diverse. And for me, I didn't want to leave the comfort zone. I didn't want to step outside of the realm of being in a space where I'm getting educated around those that look just like me. At Virginia State, and at many HBCUs, you have the opportunity to engage in getting a lucrative education around people that look like you. But not only do the individuals look like you, going to Virginia State, I understand that people have lived some of the same, through the same tragedies. And the positive things as well, we can relate more. And going to an HBCU such as Virginia State, I was able to engulf in their culture and the things that they had to offer me as an African-American male. I met a lot of different individuals, and I became close friends with people that have had some of the same struggles in life that I've had. And when you attend an institution for education with individuals that relate to you, you and the other person, or you and the party, have the ability to work together to get beyond or get past that struggle. At HBCUs, there's different things that really, really bring us together. I know with a lot of African Americans, when you have things that are tragic or you have triumph in your life, you tap into certain art forms that get your mind away from the struggle. Art forms such as music, contemporary art, dance, And I think at HBCUs, specifically at Virginia State, outside of the education, they offer such a large list of different forms of involvement and activities and organizations and clubs that you can engulf yourself into and have the opportunity to express yourself in multiple ways than just in the classroom. And I think that's what's so amazing about an HBCU, is because you have the ability, the capability, and the resources to express yourself in several different facets. Once again, my name is Tashawn D. Gaynor. I'm an alumnus of the Virginia State University, and I am HBCU made.
Hi, my name is Reina Mudani, and I'm a doctoral candidate in mechanical engineering at the North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University. Occupied. I also got my bachelor's in chemical engineering at ANT, of course, the best HBCU. And one fun fact about me is I'm from Kenya, so yes, I love traveling, yes, I love experiencing different cultures. And I'm also big on diversity and inclusion. So throughout my education career, aside from an undergraduate to right now PhD, it's been quite apparent that there are few women, and specifically Black women, in the STEM field. And that's something that I try to champion wherever I am. So whenever I get an opportunity or create an opportunity to talk to high school kids or middle school kids about like STEM, why they need to go into it, and just getting them excited about STEM field is something that I'm always on top of. Also just talking to my friends and getting them to go for their master's and PhD in this STEM field is something that I'm also big on. Probably doing it a little too much, but if it helps increase the numbers of Black women in STEM, I'm all for it. My university journey has definitely been enhanced because of ANT. I wouldn't say that experience for an experience at any other university. All the opportunities, all the connections I've been able to make just because I got an HBCU, and specifically ANT, is just mind-blowing, and I am definitely HBCU med.
Hey everyone, my name is LaTanya. I graduated from Howard University in 2013. While I was a student at Howard University, I majored in biology and I minored in chemistry. Currently, I'm a doctoral candidate at Northwestern University in the pharmacology department. I'm a member of a lab that investigates how genetic modifiers influence the broad clinical severity of epilepsy. For my specific project, I'm looking at how non-coding RNAs regulate a specific type of epilepsy called Dravet syndrome, and I'm HBCU made.
S.U. Woo! Hey everyone, my name is Amanda Turner, a junior computer science major at the illustrious Southern University and Agricultural Mechanical College located in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Along with completing my computer science degree at Southern, I also currently serve as the Region 5 Pre-College Initiative Chair for the National Society of Black Engineers, where our mission is to increase the number of culturally responsible Black engineers who excel academically, succeed professionally, and positively impact the community. I am HBCU made.
Hi everyone, my name is Nia Brown. I am an alumna of the illustrious Hampton University class of 2020, also known as Onyx 11, the Black Diamonds, and the class that was created under pressure. I attended Hampton University, where I received my Bachelor's of Arts in Communicative Sciences and Disorders, and I currently attend The Ohio State University in pursuit of my Master's of Arts in Speech-Language Pathology. My graduate degree will allow me to be a speech-language pathologist who evaluates, assesses, and treats clients with communication deficits, disorders, and delays. I can definitely say that by attending Hampton University, not only was I properly prepared to attend my PWI, but I was properly prepared for life itself. And I can for sure say that I am HBCU made.
Hello everyone, my name is Latiqua Jones, and I attended and experienced some of my best moments at the Virginia State University located in Petersburg, Virginia. There I obtained my computer science degree, and I later went on to receive my master's degree in cybersecurity. I currently work for the Department of the Army as a cyber threat analyst, and I spend a lot of my free time volunteering for organizations that promote diversity and inclusion in the workplace, as well as early exposure of STEM and STEAM concepts and careers to our youth. I am HBCU made.
Hello, my name is Dax Craig. I am the spark that makes an idea bright, and I represent the illustrious, the impeccable, the outstanding Alabama State University in Montgomery, Alabama, which is the birthplace of the Civil Rights Movement. Just to give you a little bit more about myself, I'm also a senior. I study chemistry, and I have long-term goals of being a patent attorney. And to give you a little bit about what a patent attorney is, when you have an invention, in order for it not to be stolen by somebody else and they make money off of it, you need a patent attorney, which is just another type of lawyer. And for me, that's something that interests me. I didn't want to take a traditional route and complete research, pursue a career in research. I wanted to pursue a career in law, do something different. And so with that, I'm trying to prepare now. So what I've been doing now while in college, I've been a chapter president of the National Society of Black Engineers. I've been vice president of a mentoring organization called Unite. I've been a Golden Ambassador, which is an ambassador for the university. And I've also served in student government, and everything kind of gets put together to make the person that I am today. But I would be nothing without STEM. STEM is very important. STEM is the future. The highest paid careers are in STEM. And I believe that more children should pursue degrees in STEM because, like I said, STEM is the future. And I am HBCU made.
Hi, my name is Dr. Joyanna Gamble George, and call me Dr. Joy for short. I graduated from Xavier University of Louisiana, which is ranked number one in the nation for graduating African American students with bachelor's degrees in the biological and biomedical sciences, the physical sciences, and even physics. Go, XXXU! Woo! I'm a neuroscientist, but I also serve as an expert science advisor through the AAAS Science and Technology Policy Fellowship at the National Institutes of Health. There, I advise other scientists on their implementation science research projects that focus on understanding the facilitators and the barriers to implementing interventions that help people who have HIV manage their co-occurring chronic heart and lung diseases and disorders, as well as mental illness if they've been exposed to trauma. I am HBCU May. Woo! Go HBCU!
Hello, my name is Kanisha Ford, and I am a graduate of the number one HBCU 14 years in a row, Spelman College. I graduated in 2002 with my bachelor's in physics. I am currently a PhD candidate in physics at my second HBCU, Howard University, where I study genomics and the effect environmental factors may have on the propensity for Black women to have triple negative breast cancer, a more aggressive and deadly subtype. I am also employed with the Navy in their Human Systems Engineering Division, Helmet and Auditory Group, where we test and improve the hearing and head protection that is worn by those who work with and on various aircraft. I am HBCU Maine.
Hi everybody, my name is Angelique Wakes, and I graduated from the auspicious South Carolina State University. SC State Bulldog Pride, catch it! I earned my degree in biology with a chemistry minor, and that helped prepare me to earn my master's degree in public health administration at Everglades University based in Florida. And I am HBCU Maine.
Hey family, my name is Dr. Corey Grayson. I hail from the Norfolk State University, behold. I got my bachelor's in chemistry pre-med from here. And then I went on to get my PhD in biomedical engineering from Cornell University, where I just defended not too long ago. Currently, I am a postdoctoral fellow in chemical engineering at the University of Michigan, and I am HBCU Made.
Hey family, I'm Erica Anderson, and I am a proud alumna of the Spelman College. Spelman is an all-women's historically black college and university located in Atlanta, Georgia. They're also a part of the Atlanta University Center Consortium, which is the world's largest consortium of HBCUs. Now, Spelman doesn't exactly offer an engineering degree, which is okay because they've gone and partnered with several engineering schools so that students like myself who wanted to be engineers could get an engineering degree. So I spent 3 years at Spelman, where I got my Bachelor's of Science in Math, and then I transferred to one of our partner engineering schools, Georgia Tech, where I got my Bachelor's of Science in Mechanical Engineering. I'm now a reliability engineer at ExxonMobil. As a reliability engineer, I support our refinery and chem plants by assessing the equipment for any safety and performance risks, and then developing strategies to help us mitigate those risks. And I'm also a graduate student at Texas A&M, pursuing a Master's of Science in Analytics. And lastly, but probably most importantly, I am HBCU made.
Hi, I'm Dr. Carla Hall, and I went to the Tennessee State University in Nashville, Tennessee, where I studied physics and chemistry. There, I was able to be a part of LSAMP, the Honors Program, Golden Key International Honor Society, and Beta Kappa Chi Scientific Honor Society. I also was afforded many opportunities with internships at Oak Ridge National Lab and the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. Being at a historically black college and university helped shape me into a confident black woman to enter the University of Wisconsin-Madison. At UW-Madison, I was a graduate engineering research scholar and a Boucher scholar. There, I studied nuclear engineering and got my PhD in material science and engineering. At UW-Madison, my research was geared toward nuclear materials and how they relate to material science and fusion energy. Today, I'm a process and technology development engineer at a big tech company, and I am HBCU made.
I am Dr. Adrienne Stevenson, a three-time HBCU grad. I received my bachelor's in chemistry from Lincoln University, the first historically black college and university. I also have a master's and a doctorate in pharmaceutical sciences with a specialty in pharmacology and toxicology from the Florida A&M University. I am currently an assistant dean in the graduate school at Florida State University. I am very passionate about amplifying the lived experiences and the voices of black and brown people in STEM. I do everything in my power to create outreach opportunities for younger people who look like me so that they can also see themselves in STEM. I recognize that giving them reflections of who they can become is super important. Visibility is everything. I live by the quote, "I have been given this mountain to show others it can be moved." I am HBCU made.
Hi, my name is Carmen. I'm a graduate of the Fort Valley State University. Go Wildcats. While there, I received my Bachelor of Science in Chemistry. I'm currently working as a senior forensic chemist at the Southeast Laboratory. I am HBCU made.
Attitude check. Bronco pride. Hello, my name is Kendrick Faison. I'm a graduate of Fayetteville State University. I graduated from Fayetteville State with a bachelor's degree, two bachelor's degrees, one in history and one in geography. I am currently the CEO and president of Spatial GIS, one of very few African-American-owned geospatial companies in this U.S., and I am HBCU made.
C is for Claflin, C-L-A-F-L-I-N, U University. Hey y'all, my name is Destiny Hall and I am a graduating senior, double major in biology and psychology with a minor in chemistry. I go to the illustrious Claflin University and I am HBCU made.
My name is Kayla Gamble and I go to one of the top 10 HBCU in the world, Claflin University. See you. You know, CCU, you know. I am currently a senior biology major, minor in chemistry, and I am HBCU made. Period.